So, good morning all. So, hope you had a good time yesterday evening and last couple of days on nutrition, particularly in the Indian context, maybe some few examples from the global context also, and familiar with Indian some implementation and the policy space. So feel free to ask any questions related to implementations, operations. So I'm Subrat Biswal, looking after strategy and convergence in NITI Aayog. And currently I'm associated with exclusively with the Minister WNCD, Smriti Irani Ma'am ke saath. We are meeting with the Chief Minister, so I'm part of the team to lead the discussion and set priorities at the state level. So, having a mixed experience, kind of operations, implementations, policy, mid-course corrections, India pe jo bhi hota hai, like once policy developed, like it lasts for like 8 to 10 years, and then to be mid-course correction hote chalta hai. So, like that. So, feel free to like ask question at any point or any these things. So, shall we start? Yeah. So, sorry for delay and all because of some issues, and we had some meeting also. So, there are few slides already. I think you people have covered yesterday or the day before yesterday. So, just to give a background, like why we have started this National Nutrition Mission, so-called Poshan Abhiyan in India. So, certain background, like as you know, in Indian context, irrespective of like class, caste, or the poverty scenario, like about 50%, like in every two women are anemic. So, irrespective of many times people are saying like only the rural area or the poorest, the poor area, all these things are prevalent. So, like these three conditions, like anemic, stunted, and wasted, three things really, like this is the trigger points for us or for the India to start this kind of thing. Maybe many international or the like global lobby, global pushes are there to tackle the malnutrition. So, there is the big picture over here because this whole anemic, stunted, and wasted, every third child in India are like stunted. Every fifth child is wasted. So that means like it's a national issue. But in last 60 or 70 years, like there's not much they have given priority in the implementation or nutrition investment. You can say investment in the sense like government expenditure also, you can say. So there's not much push on this space, but last couple of years, it is a good pace, it has taken good momentum on this. And for the, like for we, kind of people, for the young generations, it's like for us, it's an opportunist kind of moment to address such kind of issues as a development professional. So two things. One is like on country's GDP or the income component. Second part is the social agenda. So two big pictures in front of us to start with this kind of portion. NFHS 3 and 4, you might have like already well versed about this thing, like from in the decade, if we see NFHS 3 to 4, already have, I think, covered, Dr. Khandelwal, I think everything covered on these things. So I'll skip all these things. So this is our paired thing where NITI Aayog always, like giving this example, our mentor, Dr. B.K. Paul Saab, always giving this example, ki why we are like much more giving importance to the stunted or wasting children in India to tackle all these kind of issues. So so from NFHS 3 to 4, it has been reduced and it's continued to reduce in the CNNS and all. But if you see the comparative analysis in the, like all these developing countries, it's very, very slow and it's alarming also. So if you see many study, many literature saying, if you spend $1 on nutrition interventions, it returns like up to from 16 to the range $16 to $30. There are many studies going on. I'm not a researcher, typical researcher, I'm a typical operation position much more into strategy and this thing. And these 3 points, like the productivity, second thing is that the income, and third is like productivity in the sense skill, manual labor kind of things. So 8% productivity loss due to undernutrition is a huge loss. And second is that, but there are many debates going on. Like if you see the Northeast, their height may not increase on these things in the stunted. So can we like define the stunted children on these things? There are many debates are still going on. So the last part, the 1 cm increase in height increase 4% wages in men and 6% in women. So that's again, we need to keep it in our mind and need to start working on this thing. So as a researcher, as a like policy expert, you people, you should like work more on these things. So poverty alone does not explain malnutrition. That's very clear in Indian context. So this is again like the first 1,000 days means first 2 years of child is very, very important, where the brain growth rapidly, and after that it's grows slow. So basically these 2 years is very, very important, very critical for all the child in India, in Indian context. So if you see the Indian context, how this policy move or policy momentum has started. So in 2018, Poshan Abhiyan launched in India, and in 2017, the inception, if you see the inception, all these NFHS 4, and there are many other, so they have started like, how we'll tackle these things? Can we like, we will strengthen the WCD, can we like tackle the malnutrition in India? So what are the other components? Whether we should like align or the sync with other line departments? So there are like many policies who started, like Poshan Abhiyan se leke, like there are health and wellness center, there are HBNCs, Prime Minister PMJ, there are like Anemia Mukt Bharat. So this is the like journey started to give a momentum on these things. So Poshan Abhiyan started like it's the policy per se, like it's approved in at the government, at the cabinet level in the November 2017, but launched in the March 2018. About 9,000 crores, more than 9,000 crores has been like allotted for this particular, for this thing, for from 17-18 to 19-20. So March 20, it is going to like, again, it's going on, the process is already started, and we are working on that. I think it will be like 2024, we are expected. Maybe 2022, but the target and everything will be 2024. So this is the Poshan Abhiyan started on that background. And so what is the target? Where are we now? What was the target at that time in 2017-18? So in stunted, wasted, and low birth weight, it was decided, it's a very ambitious target to reduce 2% per annum. That means 38% to 25% by 2022. It's a very ambitious target. And it's a target not only for the Ministry of WNCD or the Ministry of Health or like other line departments, it's a target for all stakeholders. How we all together can tackle these things and contribute to this mission. And also the another target is to anemia. It's 3% per annum, both for the like children and the women. So who are the target groups? These are the 4 target groups: the pregnant women, the lactating mothers, and the newborn child, and the children 0 to 5, and adolescent girls. So these are the like 4 target groups. And initially, it was decided to start to implement in a phase-wise manner, and it's supposed to reach out to saturate by 19-20. But last year, it was decided to cover all the districts. But maybe if you see at the policy level or the implementation pace and all these things, it's not easy. It's very difficult to like scale it up with existing human resources or the bandwidth of the like government or the maybe stakeholders. But as a political and the bureaucratic process and the commitment, we need to declare and to move on these things. So we have. Last year in 2018, we have covered all the districts, and So target is about 10 crores beneficiaries across the country. So there are like 7,075 project, ICGS project. So there are like what are the platforms to start with? So in India, you know, this is an ICDS platform in the Ministry of WNCD. ICDS is the ground level implementing agencies. So there are like 7,075 projects, about 14 lakh Anganwadi centers. So field functionaries are there. So, but here we are talking about the three A's, like Anganwadi, ASA, and ANMs, and another A is like ASA, Anganwadi helper also. So all these things are the frontline workforce for us. So this is the implementation strategy for us, and the facilities where we are like, what is the platform for us? One is like the health facility centers, Anganwadi centers, BHSND is like a very good platform for to ensure the last mile service delivery, these things, and the community events and the home visits where we used to like meet all the target beneficiaries or the audience for this program. So what are the pillars of the Poshan Abhiyan? The important part is the leadership from bottom to top and top to bottom. The leadership and the creating enabling environment is very, very important. And hopefully, I think people have well versed about the first 1,000 days yesterday and like earlier in your research paper also. So you're focusing on the high impact interventions, particularly in the first 1,000 days. Convergent actions among the relevant sectors, monitoring not only that we have like you might have heard about the ICDS case, so there are many ways to monitor, track, and to support for the mid-course corrections. There are many agencies like with us, apart from the Ministry of WCD and from the government agencies like NITI, there are many other national and international stakeholders and the partners with us like IFRI, ID Insight, there are many other like reputed institutions, PHFI, there are many institutions, they are partner with Government of India to monitor and support for the mid-course corrections and strengthening policy space in India. So that's a very good strategy for us. And the last part is the behavioral change communications, as so-called we are saying is a Jan Andolan. So what are the key components of this Poshan Abhiyan over here? So address this malnutrition, one part is very, very important, the convergence. And everybody knows the convergence in Indian context and typical political and the bureaucratic structure. Those who have field level experiences, they know what is the strength, weaknesses, pros, cons, how it is, and where to start, where to like accelerate these things. So convergence is a very, very important component. So whether we are talking about resource convergence or talking about the institutional convergence, right? So here we are aiming at both, and we are trying our best even all stakeholders level. And it's not only in the portion, in every department there's a component called convergence, convergent actions, and everybody is struggling. Because everybody would like to set their own agenda and to achieve their own targets. And together, how to achieve this thing, it's a very, very... But Poshan Abhiyan has set an example in this convergent action plan or the maybe kind of the momentum. Our minister or the many senior bureaucrats from NITI and the WCD, they have started many ways. They have like maybe some kind of hit and trial, some kind of experimentation way. So we started, and there are good response from all the line ministries. So that's one. Second is the like technological interventions, so-called ICDS case common application software, where third one is like behavioral change, some kind of incentivization to all the frontline workers and all this like human resources, some innovations, how to like start with few innovations. And the important part is the capacity building, and last part is the grievance redressal. So this is the, it's a very dynamic in nature. You've started with all these things, but you are adding as and when required, as per the context and as per the requirement of those states. So few things are very, very important. for us and for the policy space also, where people are working. One is technological interventions, convergence, behavioral change, communication, and the capacity building. Four components are very, very critical. And personally, I request you all, in your future course of actions, either in the maybe in the research space or the implementation space, you should start working on this, how you can contribute in these four things, because that is very, very critical to tackle all these issues. So what is the platform for the convergence? So when we started, it looks like very theoretical. In the things at national level, we would like to involve all the line ministries. Already like about 15 ministries are coming together to work on the nutrition. Maybe the nodal agency is the Ministry of W&CD, but there are 15 departments. It's like inter-intra-relationships are there. There are many platforms like states, district, below districts like project, ICDS projects level, and the village level. So at the national level, National Council is there, which is headed, the council is headed by Vice Chairman Niti Aayog, and Executive Council is headed by the Ministry of WCD Secretary. So, and in National Council, there are many ministers, many state CM, many senior bureaucrats, many stakeholders are there. And state, district, and project level, there's a project plan, convergence action plan, which is like very systematic convergence action plan they used to prepare from the, it's a bottom-up approach. And the village level, like VHSND, village health sanitation day, community waste events, many other like NRLM platform is there, PRA platforms are there. So there are many platforms are there to like, to do. So in convergence, there are many schemes in the programs. So as I was talking about two type of convergence, like resource convergence or the institutional convergence. Like there are many schemes, programs at the state level, many centrally sponsored schemes are there. State level, state-owned schemes and programs are there. And how to minimize the duplications of the work for the same target, for the same beneficiaries, same audience, the same clients. So we are trying our best to mapping all these things, resource convergence and the institutional convergence part. So recently, Ministry of Agriculture, along with all these international partners like ERI, AgriSet, they are coming forward to join with POSHAN, because in POSHAN, the nutrition interventions, no doubt many aspects are there, but the source of nutrition is food. And in that food, agriculture is very, very important. Somehow it was missed in initial days, but now it is, everybody is coming forward and started together. So that's very, very important on these things. So about like 13 to 15 ministries are coming together with their schemes and the program to support this program. Maybe you can say NHIP, GSS, PMMBY, Midday Meal, NRLM, there are many schemes are coming together. Yeah. So what are the key strategies to accelerate this convergence, and what are the key strategies? So there are like about 15 strategies like we are talking about, where the Ministry of WCD is anchoring for this. With the help of WNCD, with the help of Ministry of Health, because if you see all the indicators, like about 70% indicators for the POSHAN Abhiyan is from the Ministry of Health. So health is the key stakeholders to tackle this issue. So like from IOSCF, food and nutrition, immunization, institutional delivery, health and sanitation, deworming. So like food fortifications, we are talking about the 15 key interventions and the strategies we are talking about to initially you should focus on this. So with this platforms and the key interventions, so what are the key, how we'll start on these things? So the key challenges for us, particularly for the implementation point of view. We have ICDS project. ICDS people, same Anganwadi workers, helper, supervisor, CDPOs. DPOs, Ministry of WCD, state, at the national level. With existing human resources, we have initiated or launched this program. without building capacity. But we have created the space for the capacity building and additional human resources. But in the last 2 years, if you see, hardly like 4 to 5 states has already engaged few human resources for the Poshan Abhiyan. Otherwise, they are like walking or the like moving or the like implementing this program with existing human resources with their existing capacities. So if you see, if you have studied in the field or if you might have seen in the field, there are about 11, it varies from state to state, it's like 11 to 17 registers they used to maintain at the Anganwadi level. And still they are like maintaining that one, and their whole energy, time, and everything, like they're spending their time, energy, and this record keeping and all these things. So this whole common application software, they've started to how to like paperless Anganwadi in the country. So how like this is a record kind of thing globally to about 14 lakh Anganwadi centers to be paperless. Maybe it may take time because it required technological interventions, it's required strong capacity building, that to be not only like one-time training on the capacity building, required like frequent updation on the technology, capacity, and all sort of things. So there's a like mobile app on mobile app and ICDS, particularly in Poshan Abhiyan, we are providing smartphones to all the Anganwadi workers, supervisor, and the senior level. And it's synced with all this mobile app for like Anganwadi level to supervisor to next level. So it's a like real-time data capturing and the monitoring system where you can like capture offline and online, and it's like multilingual and like it's like multimedia tools, GPS tagging, everything is there. If you see, there's some example you can say, and at present I don't have like the current data, but if you see up to May, how we are like, it's an example, some example like. So how many Anganwadi workers, we have started with this like governance component part, how many Anganwadis have started or operating these smartphones through this CAS, ICDS CAS, and then to like, what are the things they are capturing on these things. But beyond that, like apart from this governance or the operation things, we are also monitoring on this thing every month and every quarter, like how many children they have, like this month they have waited, and like how many are like SAM children, how many are MAM children, are how many are they have recommended, referred to the NRCs. There are many things they are like capturing, and it's reporting on time and also monitoring. Still, it requires lots of capacity building for the from the grassroots level, from the frontline workers to supervisory level. It requires lots of capacity building. There are huge issues at the capacity building from the like a delivery point of view and also operations point of view. So it's very, very important. It's one of the key topic for you people if you want to like start working on this at the field level, at in your next level. So how these technological interventions are minimizing their like time and increasing in their efficiency, implementing efficiency. Yeah. Sure.
Okay, so... yeah, in fact, two questions. So one is, you said that these data, which is real-time monitoring, is happening, and you immediately identify which are SAM children, MAM children.
Yeah.
What about overweight, obese children? What are we doing for those children? Number one. And number two, all this data, which is so much data I can see, how and why and like what are the modalities with which can involve researchers to help you? So for example, can we get our PhD students to work on some part of that or some district? What is that modality?
Okay, so first question, as you are talking about malnutrition at Indian context and all, if we go to the field, pehle to shuru hota hai ki like duble patle bacche, mote bacche ka koi baat nahi karta hai. But again, as you are saying, I had field experience in Andhra Pradesh because I was in Bijayawada for some time, with CMO Andhra. So I think two Krishna districts and other districts, they've started that one. And more than 20% kids are like into this overweight. And so they've started one thing like counseling. with the Anganwadi, like door to door. Second thing, they've started this PDS system, all fortified rice, and even they've supplied this, what is it called? Red, what is it called? Another kind of rice. Not millets, millets they've started. So at this stage, at the under portion of vision, at the policy level or the like at the implementation stage, we haven't started anything about or talking about that. But our members have already he started to talk about this, but we are keeping time of 1 year at this stage because we need to kind of strengthen the existing this thing. People should understand about like adequacy of diet. If you see the hardly NFHS 4, if you see hardly 9% the adequate diet able to have on these things. And if you see the many other many states like Bihar, UP and all, hardly like 4 to 7% all. So there is a huge issues on these things. So people are not so in Indian context, large mass they are not able to get the adequate food. So India is not food hungry. No doubt there are many challenges. Dividers are there. It's a nutrition hungry country. So we are trying to address these issues through the behavioral change communication strategy. And later on, our team, internal team, research team, and the policy team have started working on the obese part. But you're not, I think, strategically, you're not moving on this obese part. But these are the key challenges for the future generations and the coming, like, next 2 to 3 years. So that's one. Second part is the data part. Yeah, I'll complete first.
So when we come across these children, what we did in Assam with the state level policy, we're trying to bridge these kids to the NRC. So NRC usually have a dietitian. So who will counsel not only the SAM as well as obese children. But as of now, we do not have any set of guidelines on what to counsel, what needs to be counseled, what needs to be tailored to him. And then there is no field level guidelines as well as for Anganwadi worker, otherwise ASHA or ANMs, to how to counsel, kya khana chahiye, kya nahi khana chahiye, waisa kuch guidelines wagera nahi hai. But as of now, we are just trying to bridge that kid to the health system. So health system, pediatrician as well as dietitian will take care at the health system itself. So, I mean, there is urgent need to develop such guidelines, you know, to address as well as design and intervention.
So we are focusing much into right foot at the right time for the child and the mother. So we are talking about then. Second part is the data part. No doubt, ICDS CAS is not in the public domain at this stage, and it's still not in the experimentation. But still, it's not able to saturate all the Anganwadi centers and all. So. Still, many things are both technological obligations, data, many errors are going on because of the capacity building issues and all. So at this stage, it has not been like publicly, they have not been given it in the public domain. So it takes time, but at the field level, from the district and the block level, you can ask to the CDPOs and the DPOs. So maybe case-to-case basis, they can share for the research point of view. But the country level, it will take some time at this stage. Yes. But the field level, you can get.
I have addition to this what you about the data part, how the data actually flows at the field level is that whenever this ICDS CAS data enters in mobile, so all the block level officials as well as district level officials and the state level officials do have username and password for the dashboard. So we get a good robust data, but unfortunately the implementation part is suffering very badly, that some data comes from only few districts and other districts are not reporting because it's initial stage. From the central level, we do not have any such guidelines to sharing this data to public forum for research and everything, but they have given some flexibility to the state level officials to converge with any other department and use this data for any research purpose. For example, what we did in Assam is, we converged with a university called Tejpur University, which is a university in Tejpur, and then which has a social science school, everything. So what we did is that from the state level, we signed an MOU between university and then SPMU Assam, in which some of the master students who are about to write their thesis, they can use some of the data from this ICDS, this thing. So that's what
it's a state issue.
But the it's a
state level policy. It's a national level. At the NITI also, we are also struggling. Poonima, ma'am, it's here. We are struggling on these things at the, like, because our data partner are the maybe guy, it is IFRI, and they are supporting us for the, all this data management or the maybe kind of all the analysis and all sort of for the NITI. But all of us are struggling together because of the many internal or the technical issues on this thing. So maybe state to state level, you may approach to the CDPOs and all. So they have right to, if they may not share the password and all sort of things, but they can share HN when required as per the requirement of your research study and all sort of things. Yep, ma'am.
I just want to add a comment on that and say one more thing. I mean, what's most important to remember here is that even though the system of, you know, ICDS-CAS is set up to deliver data all the way to the state and the national level, at the end of the day, the only people who can really act on, you know, whether it's an identified case of malnutrition or anything else, those actions happen at a very local level, right? So what we need is that in every state and in every district, in fact, people are having conversations about how do you actually use that data in a way that changes what happens for children, not just to keep reporting up. I mean, in a sense, by putting in the system that automates some of the reporting and gets things into dashboards, hopefully we are removing the reporting burden on the people who should be doing program delivery work. So, you know, that's something that I think is still an ongoing conversation, because the culture of data in Indian program systems has been very much more about reporting up than about use. And we'll actually, when Divya will be in the next, Divya Nair will be in the next sessions as well. And these are things that we are really trying to work hard on, to understand cultures of data use and how to transform them, not just for reporting, but also for local use. The one other comment I wanted to make, and maybe, Subrat, you don't know about this piece of work because we are still pulling that up. In about four states, we've done some active sort of field-based research looking at the quality of growth monitoring. So remember, what goes into the CAS system is what an Anganwadi worker measures and puts into the system, right? There's a whole chain of things that happens before that that she has to do very well, which is to make sure that children are measured correctly, to transfer that information correctly into the systems. And so in the four states that we've done these assessments, we find significant challenges, especially with the field level measurement of things like height, and we're consolidating findings, and, you know, we'll be sharing it with people like Subrat and Neeti and WCD. So these are other things that, you know, state governments and district officials need to really think about. What is the quality, not just is there data coming into the system. I think for the last several months, that's been a big point of discussion, because to get ICDS-CAS working, people needed to make sure that, you know, it was working, that people were actually engaging with the system. Now you can really push to say, okay, is the quality of what's going into that really at the frontline level? How do we make that even better so that, and then how do we change how or support people to actually use that data at a level where the action needs to happen? It is much less useful for the minister here to know that a child is malnourished than for her Anganwadi worker to know that a certain family needs attention, right? So I think there's a lot of things that we're all, you know, it's a collective effort of working through.
So it's very, very important what Poonima is saying. So the purpose is supposed to be clear before you asking about the data and how to use the data on this thing. So maybe for the all researchers' point of view, it should be very clear how you would like to use this data and what level you are going to add value to these things. So the four states will really add value to the implementing efficiency and the clarity at the all the level. Maybe it's from Anganwadi to senior, like the implementing level, maybe state and the national level. So it's very, very important to how we are going to use this data and at what level we are asking for the data and what kind of data we are asking. So it's very, very important. So as it is, still it's an ongoing process going on. So personal request to everyone, as and when required, please request to all your like field level functionaries and the state and get the data. Yeah.
So, you are from?
CBG, Center for Budget.
Okay. So, you are asking a typical government question.
In government system, though you are working in the typical government, at the collector level or the secretariat level, from Jan to March is the time for monitoring them. What is the physical progress and what is the financial progress? Right. Both the things they used to monitor very closely, because they are much more accountable to these things. Implementations and outcome and the process are the least important for them. So for us, for the new generations, for the development professionals, we need to focus much more on all sort of things and also push for the expenditure efficiency also, as you are talking about the budget and all. So it is there. We are focusing on this. Okay, like how much percentage you are like spending money on which area and all. So we are working on that. And we see in the WCD website, it is there, like from Government of India, in the different phases, how much money they have transferred to the state government. But from state, it is not clear how much money they have like transferred to the district and the below. Many districts are still struggling to organize their events, even like Jharkhand and a few other states. Even the district and the block level, they are not spending money because they are not getting money from the states. The states are sitting with all this money. So there are some issues are there. So national level, you can get, like it's from the public domain. For the states, you need to approach the state and the district. Yeah.
To add just a few estimation, to implement this portion again in a state, for example, in Assam with a population of 35 million, nearly around 1,500 crores have been given in 2018. But unfortunately, Assam is not in a phase to implement in 2018, but he started to implement in 2019. So in 2018, hardly 200 crores were spent out of 1,500 for last year. But this time, majorly out of 1,600 crores, we could able to spend around 1,200 crores, you know, in phase wise. So I mean, there's huge financial support from the, you know, WCD department to implement this program.
I agree with that. Just the point is that we can actually access data to state,
right,
below that.
Right.
We do not know how much one district is spending,
mm-hmm,
or one center for say.
Two things.
Spending.
One is like you need to understand like what is the district budget, what is the demand,
what is the district demand on this thing, and what is the state has like transferred this money to the district. Two things you need to understand from the state. And from central level, they have already allocated and they estimated the budget for the states. From state and below, it's a state agenda. And the district on the demand, two things. Some states are doing on the demand basis. Some states are doing on the like on the allocation basis. So it so it's a state to state varies. But we are suggesting, as per that she's saying, the estimations as per the population or the maybe Anganwadi wise, they used to like calculate on these things. It's a very simple scheme actually. Poshan Abhiyan, if you see the scheme and the all the components, it's very simple. It's not complex at all. There are 4 or 5 components and like very clear cut like estimation of the project and all, like procurement, capacity building, Jan Andolan, and human resources. What else? 4 or 5 things, not more than that, right? So it's a very simple project, not like other projects like livelihoods project or the some other kind of project. It's a very simple project. So key component, earlier also, like there are many projects and the schemes, they have the component of behavioral change communications, but how to convert this behavioral change communication into a Jan Andolan, so like people's movement. So under Poshan Abhiyan, we've started this one as like a Jan Andolan strategy, where we would like to have like different teams. We are using different platforms, different activities, how to like see the context-specific behaviors, what are the kind of material you're supposed to use, the messages and all, like Poshan Ma, Poshan Pakwada, you know, in 18, 19, and the 19, this year also we did. So two are the like the benchmark for the Indian context, how the particular the outreach and the inclusivity. So two things we have done. So the huge, it is like each and every district, they have responded well. All the communities, all the platforms, like platform in the sense like many ministries, departments at the ground level, like Panchayat Raj institutions, self-help groups, many local clubs, like all the NGOs, NGO partners, civil society organizations, development partners, they are all coming for, all coming together to like sensitize and to like, to motivate all the people to talk about the nutrition. Nutrition is one agenda where the future is there for the children and the mother and the whole society. So irrespective of like male, female, girls, like child, old age and everything, everybody is included in this person mind, person pakwada, everybody I think well versed about this thing. So the important part is like the capacity building. So in WNCD earlier, if you see their earlier model like in ICDS project, ICDS 1 and ICDS 2, so they have also like system approach or the maybe very structural capacity building program. Here under Poshan Abhiyan also like there is structural, like very structured way of capacity building program for field functionaries, supervisory staff and the state and the national level staff. And the important part is for the all this frontline workforce, it's like ILA model. This is incremental learning approach model. There are 21 modules.
But after the restructured and there's a like a mid-course corrections after implementing in the few states, now it is we can complete it in 10 and a half months. It's a very systematic training program. So there are district level resource group, block level resource group, and the frontline workforce. So everybody will be part of their capacity building program. But there are huge capacity building gaps, what the Punya man is saying about like. Measurement is there or not at the field level, whether the people have the capacity or not. So you people may take small project in your like research project to understand in the capacity building issues or maybe implementation issues or the many areas. So there are modules are there, whether the traders are well versed about these things, whether the if they are delivering, imparting the training, whether the frontline workforce, they have the capacity. And which is developed by all the stakeholders. I think World Bank played a key role, PMGF had a key role on this thing with the care support for this ILA model. For the, this ILA model, it's a very good model. And now this other countries are now coming forward to learn about this, how this ILA module are like delivering at the field level. So still it required lots of like mid-course corrections, further capacity building, continuous engagement with all the workforce and the trainers for future development. So apart from these things, there are three components in this program they have added. One is innovations. So state has their own space to have some creative and the innovative approach to tackle the malnutrition. For that innovation fund is there, about per district, about 27 lakhs is there for the innovation. And flexi fund is about from out of total budget, about 7% of their total budget is for the flexi fund. So they have huge money to do some kind of innovative approach, context specific approach to tackle this kind of issues or to maybe showcase to other districts. So, and next part is the incentivizations approach. The incentives are really helps maybe like in a different program, people are like giving either monetary incentives or many are like maybe non-financial intensive incentives. So here, the portion of Abhiyan talking about the both like financial and non-financial incentives. So no doubt there are exclusive budget is allocated for that. Last year we did, and about like for the national awards, about 20 crores or about 21 crores we have distributed at the national awards up to like Anganwadi workers, and the state and below about 35 crores are allotted for this thing for the award, and it's really a really good boost to all the workforce and the national, the state and the local. Yeah.
So the innovation funds is very interesting, very useful thing on field level.
Yeah.
So innovation funds are at state level as well as district level.
Yeah.
So I was interested to know,
Have any states or district already utilized the funds to, you know, create innovative solutions? And is there a repository at what all they have innovated with? So
like Himachal has done few, Bihar has done few, Assam one or two districts they have done. Like it's like a piecemeal or maybe like they are doing on their own way. But it's that as you are saying, there's a requirement of like repository.
Many states are asking about the is there any kind of framework or the formats to design this innovative proposal. So everywhere the demand is there, but we are talking about the state is a real resource agency to like to understand their own context and also the solutions. So we have given some budget, but it's not limited to like 27 lakhs now.
Now the ministry has already communicated, it's not limited to like 27 lakhs at all, but you can start with like whatever your project proposal and all, you should go ahead on these things. So state has now like independent authority to design the project proposal and to implement on these things.
And after that,
we need to have some kind of focusing, some kind of proof of concept of this model. Then only we can like document and to start go for the repository or to recommend someone. Because we need to understand the, what is the impact, what is the like whether this project or the, this model is really scalable or to it is really applicable in the other context or not. So this is very, very important to understand the kind of proposal and the implementation and the impact and the scalability of the program. So that's why we have not yet started the kind of collecting the best practices. So later on, we are going to start with the to collecting or the documenting as the best practices, particular approach. Like some areas like, maybe you can see, you can think about like Sitamani, the TFR is very high, maybe in some other districts. So the district is talking about, now they are talking about like even they have the maximum number of SAM children in the Sitamani. Right, in each and every Anganwadi center, 6 to 7 children are there, or the like SAM children, but they are not able to recommend or the report because only one the district headquarter, only 20-bedded NRC is there. There are many issues are there.
So how to start with these things? The district collector has started, no doubt. He was a doctor, now they transferred to some other district. So So at that time, they started how to use this money. So for the TFR, they started with like faith-based, with UNICEF and other people, they started on this one, faith-based leaders, how to sensitize faith-based leaders, because like faith-based leaders are like sensitized. And but it's not an, for TFR, like fertility and for TFR, the family planning and all, only counseling, it won't work. So they have started multiple approach on these things. So for the SAM children, they have started like to go to not to district level, even to the above block, like subdivision level. So they've created all this platform, but not yet like implemented on this. They have been, the ideas are in their own mind and even the project level, not at the implementation level. There are many ideas in some other states, other districts, but not yet a concrete ideas to recommend someone to this is the best model or the approach to start with.
Right. So my point was not consolidating good practices.
Yeah.
But even, you know, people, what they are doing at their place, even if we get to read. So a big challenge, so I'm coming from WCD Maharashtra office.
Okay.
I'm reporting to Honorable Secretary there.
Okay.
So one thing I would like to have is, what Karnataka WCD is trying to do, what Andhra Pradesh is trying to do, what Assam is trying to do. Even there could be some platform where, you know, people tell ki what we are, how we are trying to understand our problem, how we are trying to, you know, find solutions for it, how we are prioritizing solutions. That would, you know, can give lot of insights. A knowledge sharing platform,
yeah, yeah.
Probably even could be a Facebook page.
Already we have started that one to visiting states and collecting all this, not only the best practices kind of thing, what are the different approaches in the process so that they are able to build the capacity and to address the real issues, real-time issues. So we have started that kind of things, and maybe it will take another 6 to 7 months to come out with the next. Last year we did a compendium of best practices, and this year we are trying not on the innovations point of view, but it's a kind of scalable kind of model. So we are trying to collate and to share with all the states. Last year we have shared to all the states one called Practice Insight Compendium. So I think this year also, by end of March, I think we are going to do another one, but still going on. So you can talk offline if you have any Assam experience, so you can say. So there's no ready-made answer for all these kind of questions.
Sure. Yeah. There is actually a repository. I mean, it's public in it. All these best practices, which is collected by CPMU. And then very recently, there was a regional workshop on innovative practices which had happened. I think it was Northern region, right? I think Northern region workshop by in which? By ORF. A lot of innovations from a lot of other states have been discussed. And then, unfortunately, we just saw that only in the YouTube, and then good practices from Haryana as well as from, you know, Gujarat and everything have been discussed. So those we can actually implement. Even Assam also, we face this issue of which practice to implement and do we have repository for everything. I think there is no such repository as of now.
Sir, please carry on.
Okay, thank you.
So if you see, where are we now? So there are many indicators. I'm not going to discuss details, but just giving an overview, where are we now as a, like a portion of vision, where like Niti Aayog, WCD, other line ministries, IFRI, everybody was part of that team to analyze some kind of preparedness status, where the portion of vision is going on. So as per this thing, like have divided into three kind of like large states, small states, and the UTs, and on their governance, institutional mechanism, and all this preparedness, still many states has to like they have to take bold step to improve their operational efficiency. So this is the preparedness as per our last report. So many states like Assam, Kerala, Karnataka, Telangana, and all these states, they have to do lots of work to accelerate this portion of vision program. Like small states, like few states like Sikkim, Nagaland, these people are doing well. Like UTs and all, the other end, like Chandigarh, these people are doing well. So details is not there, details in our internal report. But this is the just overview where the status, where the current status of the portion of vision after this, after 1.5 years of the program. So still many states has to do lots of work, groundwork, particularly in the on the governance and the institutional mechanism to at par with the national standard. So if you see on the impact of the like outcome, as everybody, I think on CNNS yesterday or the day before yesterday might have gone through these things. So no doubt, the Indian target is about 2% we need to reduce on, by 2022 we need to reduce every year 2%, but the current rate is like more than 1%. It's a good sign, but it's very, very slow. And not only all the ministries, but all the stakeholders has to join together to tackle these issues and to address these issues. So current status is from like 5-6 to 16-18, like 48 to 34.7%. No doubt the methodologies are different, but still we are, hypothetically we are agreed to like focus on how the stunting rate are reducing at this stage, underweight and the wasting all the same. So no doubt it's like good news for all of us. India is improving on this, but the pace, the speed, and the kind of outreach, inclusivity, so we need to improve on all sort of things. So what are the key issues and the challenges at this stage? So important part is here, the engagement of leadership from top to bottom is very, very important. Few states are really good, at their leadership level, from the ministers to state bureaucrats level. And in the Indian context, you know, like ek bureaucrat or the secretary or the director or collector ko hardly 1 year or 2 years dete hain, but this kind of program, mission mode approach, it required consistency and continuous approach at the leadership level. But Indian context, it's a challenging task to retain a good leader for the particular program and the schemes. So in my career, like 12 years of experience working with the government, I think I have worked with 15 bureaucrats as my director and in my 12 years of career. No doubt I have very good rapport with everyone till now. That's a different case altogether. But every year we used to see the new face, and all the bureaucrats, they would like to showcase themselves that they are more efficient and all these things. But in a mission mode kind of project, we need good leader. We should not say the definition of the good leader at the bureaucracy, because in the government we have to accept as it is at the kind of program. But we are talking about the both political commitment and bureaucratic structure, strengthening the structure and all sort of things. Luckily, we got a very good minister over here this time. I should not compare, but she is focusing. And she, particularly our minister, is trying hard to reach out to all the chief ministers to set an agenda. Nutrition issue is a priority for the state and the future of India. So that component, she is traveling, meeting personally, irrespective of their political agenda. But as a like a one thing, as a human being, as a like a real issues at the child and mother, so she's talking on that language. So many chief ministers, irrespective of BJP or the Congress or any kind of things, they are accepting the idea and joint hands together to address this kind of issues. So many flexibility the ministry and Ministry of WNCD has given to the state. So it's a good sign for us, and to you, we see next 5 years this should continue, the same tempo should go on. The key challenges, if you see the human resources, we have the existing human resources. Recently I visited to, I think, Dumka, Jharkhand, and most of the CDPOs and the supervisor, they are going to retire, I think, in a couple of months. And there's no such kind of policy. Even a portion of vision ka jitna bhi staff tha, they haven't recruited so far. Even government ka jo gadget notification hona chahiye for the CDPO and the supervisor recruitment, so government has not yet started. So with existing human resources, with existing like capacity and the bandwidth, we are imposing new scheme in a mission mode, right? So we are giving new pressure, new burden to them. So how to like boost this thing with like in the existing human resources? So it's a key challenge for everyone. So if you see the Bihar and the UP, more than 47% vacancies are there at the supervisory level. Anganwadi workers and the helper, almost is saturated, it is there. But the supervisory and above level, who will guide these Anganwadi workers? And they are like already burdened with not only ICDS projects, burdened with many things. School time, like examination time, they have many states, like in Bihar, if you see, they are deputed to the schools for the security check-in, or even the some classroom, some other kind of like on all examination chart. Census, maybe a sanitation audit, some kind of energies audit. Many Anganwadi workers are burdened with not only in the ICDS kind of program, with many other things. So that we need to see. One is vacancies, second is the capacity and the kind of engagement you are talking about. So same thing for the PMMBY. Though ICDS, Poshan Abhiyan, they have like exclusively allocated budget for the recruitment or the maybe to engage the human resources, but hardly like 20-25% states are like engaged human resources under Poshan Abhiyan. So and second thing is that like no doubt, like by end of this year, I think we are going to procure all the smartphones and going to saturate or to reach out to all the Anganwadi centers. Next part is to how to operate, how to implement these things, how to build the capacity of all the Anganwadi workers and the supervisory level. So that part, next level is the growth monitoring devices. Already have given SNIF states, like before like Poshan Abhiyan, SNIF states, World Bank funded projects are there. So what is their capacity, what is their bandwidth to do the right way of measurement and the right way of reporting? There's the critical issues. So that is the critical issues. We are waiting for the four state issues from the IFRI, how they have done these things and how we can build the next level of agenda to set agenda for the ministry. So next, that we are talking about. As you are talking about budgetary and all fund utilizations, up to March it was like 20%. I think now it is up to 35%. Below 5%, like Haryana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Kerala, Delhi, Goa, all these things are having like utilization rate is hardly 5%. It's a, like in last 1.5 years, it's a very difficult task. Data and progress monitoring already have discussed. It's a, we are talking about the real-time monitoring, but at the same time, we are talking about the right way, right approach of monitoring and the correct method of data capturing, sharing, and then next level. So that we need to talk about. And critical part is the behavioral change, particularly like how to design and develop the communication strategy for all level from the national level to state to up to Anganwadi level. So the communication strategy is very, very important. And few recommendation priorities for this year we are talking about. Can you have like in Indian context, zero diarrheal death, ZDD, you are talking about that. So if no, can you eliminate diarrheal death by improving sanitation or treatment to zinc and ORS, some vaccinations and all. So can you have some kind of things, diarrhea component that's in our hand? It's a behavioral change issues, it's a supply side issues, it's a demand side issues. Huge campaign on the complementary feeding. It's a very, very important how to like counsel or to reach out to each and every family to give the right food at the right time, right mix of foods also. And what are the components of the complementary feeding and all. Home-based newborn care, how to improve the quality. So two things important. One is the capacity building of our all frontline workforce. Second, how to deliver, how to counsel the household, the member at the household level. Third part, what the impact on this. So HBNC is very, very important at this stage. Fourth one is the how to accelerate the Anemia Mukt Bharat campaign, 3T. Test, treat, and talk, no doubt, but we need to improve on this and improve the delivery and supply of take-home rations at this stage. So four or five things apart from all these issues we have discussed, if we can improve on these things, gradually you can fulfill some kind of agenda or portion of vision at this stage. Yeah.
Can you go back to your brief?
Yeah.
So in your last bullet, improve the composition, delivery, and supply. I think we have been talking for the last 3 days about the composition of take-home rations also, which is very high in sugar. And the whole, the CNNS data, for example, is showing that we are having these things creeping in. So I think somewhere we will need to go back and take stock of what we are giving and to whom are we giving those. So maybe improve the delivery, supply, and composition. If that comes from
so noted. Like, thank you. Yep.
Sorry, can I also ask?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so I didn't earlier because I didn't want to interrupt. In your previous slide where you have shown the preparedness of states, so I wanted to understand one of the states that we are looking at.
Which state?
We are looking at Gujarat.
Okay, great.
At the moment. So, I mean, how do you measure preparedness of states?
Okay, would you like to? Yeah, please. Yeah. So.
Give the mic, please, so that we get that recorded.
Purnima is our mentor for this.
Well, we're just supporting Neeti. So, these particular elements of preparedness come from surveys that were administered to state governments. So, basically, taking. You know, there's the core elements of Poshan Abhiyan, so the rollout of the technology, the HR capabilities, the
Subdivided into three groups: governance, institutional management, capacity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so we had questions that were sent out to the state governments,
yeah.
and they basically reported in what the situation was there, and then we quantified that and created an index and then sort of put this out. And the way that we've been working and supporting the, you know, these are 6 monthly monitoring reports
yeah.
on the mission. And in the first year of the mission, we really focused just on implementation preparedness, not so much, you know, what's happening with the actual program delivery and things like that. I think we're hoping in the next couple of rounds of
yeah.
the monitoring reports that we would report more on that. But this is really looking at administrative preparedness to roll out the key components of the national
mission, yeah.
which include the technology component, the behavior change component. And again, you know, the first report on this focused on WCD. The next one brought in WCD
and health.
And so, you know, it's progressively sort of starting to hopefully bring in and recognize that all the sectors need to kind of, you know, play their part. I think some of the issues and challenges, in a sense, will be, you know, all of this is still very much sitting within the ambit of public service provision.
Yeah.
And what we know from the NFHS surveys and all the other surveys we do is that the citizens, the client populations of services go to many different places as well. And so I think in, you know, in subsequent phases of work on the mission, there'll also have to be work to look at, you know, what's actually happening with private service provision, where are people going, you know, are private providers also doing nutrition-related counseling and antenatal care and all those kinds of things. But for now, you know, pushing and supporting the public machinery is something that the government can do and seems to be pushing hard. So. This is an internal report.
This is a very internal report, and we are reporting to Honorable Prime Minister's office. And some part, I think, from next couple of round, I think we are going to share with all the stakeholders, even in the public domain. Not that bulky one, but we'll write a kind of maybe fact sheet kind of thing, or maybe brief note on the state-wise or the national level kind of picture. So that will be helpful for everyone. So because it's like a preparatory page for the portion of vision and for the whole ministry, so we're trying on this thing.
You want
yeah.
to play that video?
Yeah.
So if there's any question, please feel free to ask. I'm loading
the
video.
So we have started, like, there are many players coming forward to do some kind of innovative approach. So ministry and NITI and other partners, they are coming forward to how to, like, bring all the partners in one platform to address these issues. So there are many good players in the country, at the state level, at the national level, how to bring their talents, their resources, their approaches, context-specific, their skill set, and to address these things. So it's very, very important. We are trying our best to bring all these partners together into one platform. So just a thank you, Anganwadi Didi. Just would like to here. Say.
चौंतीस साल हो गए आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ता के तौर पर इस गांव में. यहाँ का हर बच्चा मेरी आंखों के सामने ही पला बड़ा है. देखते ही देखते गांव आगे बढ़ता गया और मैं वहीं की वहीं रह गई. कल यहाँ से जाने के बाद क्या यही गांव वाले मेरा योगदान याद रखेंगे? अगर मुझसे कोई पूछे कि मैंने 34 सालों में क्या हासिल किया तो मैं क्या जवाब दूंगी?
बचाने के लिए थैंक यू. हमें समय पर उपहार देने के लिए धन्यवाद। आपने रोज जो दलिया हमें दिया वो ना तो सिर्फ स्वादिष्ट था बल्कि उसने हमें तंदुरुस्त भी रखा।
मैडम, क ख ग से LLB तक का रास्ता आपने ही दिखाया था। इस सफर को शुरू करवाने के लिए थैंक यू।
मुन्नी की इस दुनिया में आने की खुशखबरी उसके पिताजी से पहले मैंने आपको दी थी। गर्भ के हर कदम पर मेरा हाथ थामने के लिए धन्यवाद। मुन्नी को 6 महीने की उम्र तक सिर्फ माँ का दूध पिलाने की सीख आप ही तो दी थी।
ये हमारी छोटी बहन हमसे ज्यादा सियानी हो गई है। हमारी गोद भराई से लेके मुन्नी के अन्नप्राशन और उसकी भी गोद भराई तक हमारा साथ देने के लिए बहुत धन्यवाद।
क्या आप जानते हैं कि गर्भ से जीवन के पहले 1000 दिन बच्चे के पोषण और दिमागी विकास के लिए महत्वपूर्ण होते हैं और उसके भविष्य को आकार देते हैं। कृष्णा देवी की तरह भारत में रोज 13 लाख आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ता एक लक्ष्य के साथ घर से निकलती हैं। हजारों माओं और बच्चों के भविष्य को संवारने का लक्ष्य, उनका हौसला बनाए रखने के लिए आप भी अपने गांव की आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ता का हाथ बटाएं, उनको धन्यवाद कहिए।
Thank you for watching this, and thanks to not only like Anganwadi worker, all AAA, ASA, Anganwadi, No Doubt video started with like it's a kind of gratitude to all the Anganwadi workers, the lead workforce. So ANM, Anganwadi, ASA, they are the real workforce, they are the driving force for all of us. And we are like how we can join hands, not only to like in a many research paper, many in the government sector if we see. The mindset is that if you see any research paper or any kind of monetary report you are giving to any bureaucrat, they are saying that you are complaining or you are like giving some kind, you are the fault finding kind of institution. So be careful on like how you are dealing with the systems. So I'm just balancing the things. So how all your policy measures or the policy recommendations or the data monitoring reports and all will really enable the government or the state functionaries to incorporate in their implementation process. So it's a personal request to everyone, be a catalyst and a change maker and to join hands for this momentum. Thank you all.